At the age of 42, my wife is currently trying to organise a grown-up play date for me to go on with another man in order that I make a friend. It's true. I don't need your sympathy. I don't need your sympathy. I'm very happy. I'm not lonely, but I moved house. We had a long-distance relationship, and then I moved. I left the city that I love to be with the woman I like. And the difficulty I have... You're clapping too hard, sir. That tells us more about your life than mine. The difficulty I now have is that I don't meet other dads of young children, people I've got stuff in common with. They all work during the day and socialise in the evening. I have to socialise during the day because I work in the evening because of you. And as a result, I meet other cool mums, but I always meet them through baby swimming classes, and it's just me and 9 mums in bikinis, and you can't make friends with them because it's hard. I'm sorry, I don't respect you at all. The difficulty that I have is now we met this one guy, Ollie, a perfectly nice guy. Ollie seems like a nice guy. We met him for 5 minutes at a toddler rave. That's how I'm spending my Sunday afternoons now, a toddler rave. 3 hours of banging electronic dance music on a Sunday afternoon, 100 parents, twice as many kids. All the kids are running around ripped to the tits on fruity pouches, and the grown-ups are making awkward small talk. I remember this one very clearly because there's always a costume theme. There's like a dress-up theme, and the theme at this particular one was superheroes. And I remember there was one particularly attractive younger mum had come as Catwoman, and all of the other mums were there just like, "Oh, piss off!" It was just very sweet. So we got chatting to the guy, lovely guy, friendly guy, for 5 minutes, and then we wandered off, and ever since then, my wife has been stalking him on Instagram in order to pimp him to me as a potential friend. She's like, "Check it out, Ollie's into martial arts and board games, and you know, you really like board games and talking about martial arts. You should hang out." But suddenly it's reduced me to the position of like being a toddler on the first day of playgroup. She's going, "Go on, you'll enjoy it." And I'm like, "I don't want to," like that. It's pathetic. That's not how men make friends. I have written, like typed out and then deleted an introductory text message to this guy. I don't know how many times, because I have no idea how to package myself as a potential friend. I'm like, "Hello, mate." "Hey, buddy." "Ew, who am I? I don't know who I am." It's preposterous. It's easy for her. She can just go up to women in the street. It seems women can just say hello to each other. "Hey, shall we be friends? Let's go for a coffee." And bang, they're friends. It's not like that for men, is it? No. You've got the kids you knew at school, minus one who died, and that's it. And that's how it's always been. I just find myself in this peculiar position. Like, I don't even really speak with the men in my life that I love. My best friend, Noel, I love the guy to bits. I've known him 30 years. We've travelled the world together. I'll go and see him for a crafty pint. I'll come home. My wife will say to me, "How's Noel?" And I literally won't understand the question. How? How is Noel? He is simply Noel. Immutable, unchanging. He reminds me of me. I remind him of him. That's why we hang out. I can tell you what he thought of the new Spider-Man film. Is that what you mean? Is that how he is? Is that what you're talking about? And then she'll say something weird like, "Well, hasn't his mum been ill?" I don't know. How do you know that? Stop asking my friends questions, you weirdo. It's absolutely absurd. I don't really speak with him. We don't talk with one another. We just sit there and conversationally groom one another like a pair of orangutans on a log in Borneo, picking fleas out of each other's fleeces. "Did you like the film?" "Yes, I did like the film. Yes, I thought it was good. Yes, you're like me. Yeah. Did you watch Black Mirror the other day?" "Yes, I didn't like it to begin with, but then I did like it at the end. Yes, I'm the same. Yes, yes." Genuinely pathetic. I made the mistake of doing this material at a show near where I live. And a woman tweeted at me, I'd never met her before, she tweeted at me the following day and she said, "Hey Stu, just so you know, I really enjoyed that material the other night about the grown-up play date, but just in case you need to know, my friend Dan actually doesn't live far from here and he's freelance, so he's free." That's not what this is! This is not like the platonic equivalent of a so-called pussy line, forgive me, that's a horrendous comedy industry term, for when some swaggering bro comedian struts out on stage and starts doing material about how he's just broken up with his girlfriend, but he happens to be amazing in the sack, in an attempt to pick up members of the audience after the show. This is not the platonic equivalent of that. This is not me walking out here and saying, "Hello, men. I am quite lonely and I wish to play Settlers of Catan." I mean, it's not that.